Hey you, welcome back to the 4G experience. My name is George and I'll be showing you around. In the first video, I kind of did like a quick introduction video to just show you what we have going on here. I showed you from a distance the compost pile, the nursery in progress. Showed you the raised beds, the existing garden that we had here last year, and the banana runs. So this video is just going to be really just about the compost area. Compost, soil, you know, and what we're doing here and how we're doing it. So over here, as you can see, I've made two compost bins, and they're both made out of pallets. I got these pallets from my brother's job. They do a lot of shipping and receiving, and they have plenty of these laying around. So I asked him if he'll let me have a few of them, and he was kind enough to do so. All I did was butter them up together, kind of lined them up, drilled them together. Got two pallets deep, two pallets wide for each section. So that's that. For our compost pile, gathered up all the leaves from the fall and winter. We started throwing in a lot of, kitchen scraps and greens and just things that we could throw in there to add nitrogen to it. Towards the end of the winter, it pretty much went anaerobic on me. No matter what I did, I couldn't get it to heat back up. So this spring, as the grass started growing, I mowed the lawn, gathered up all the grass clippings that I could get. Mixed it all in there and everything. So hopefully that worked. It's been about a week and a half. So let's go in here and see if it's working. I don't have one of them long compost probe thingies, but I got this. Ooh, and that's hot. That is hot. Here, I don't know if you can see that steam coming up, but that is hot. It's about 75 degrees here. We got an overcast. Weatherman says it's gonna rain today. So I'll try to get this video in here as quick as I can, but look at that. That is, whew, that's pretty warm. Fogged up my glasses, look at that. So that's working. Great deal. That's great to know. That should be cooking up pretty fine. Okay. Let's check out our second pile. Same thing, grass clippings. Don't leave that laying around. Just for safety sakes. That belongs there. So anyway, let's see what this guy is doing. Same thing, grass clippings mixed in the spring, and pretty much stayed anaerobic through the winter. But let's get in there. Oh wow, this is just as hot. Look, I got some dry stuff in there. Oh, they probably came from here, but look at that. I really hope you can see that steam. It smells good. Don't do that. Ray at Praxis, eat your heart out, man. Okay, well that's working just fine. Okay. Yeah. I think I tasted them papayas. I don't know. Okay, let's move on over here. We had all this dirt. This is what they at the nursery is they're calling garden mix. As you can see, it just looks like sand, some topsoil. There is a little bit of compost in there, some wood chips. As you can see, some wood chips, and I use that as my medium for the raised beds. Here we have same soil, just mixed with pea gravel. And these here we use it for our fruit trees, for our banana trees that like a lot of good drainage. We have a small orchard going here, and later on in the season we'll be adding a few more trees, and I'll be sure to take a video of that and possibly take y'all to the nursery where we go buy these trees. Be my first field trip. John, eat your heart out. Back here we have what they call compost there at that nursery. About 2 yards of this. And if you're gonna buy soil and you have a large gardening project, the best way to go is go to one of them big lots that have big old piles of soil, compost, mulches, and buy it by the yard. You'll need a truck, or you'll need a truck and a trailer. If you buy it by the yard, it comes out a whole lot cheaper. I think I got a yard of this for $45. That's 3 feet by 3 feet by 3 feet cube. The garden mix, I got it for like $35 a yard. So compare that to going to buy a bag of this stuff, which costs about seven something sometimes, of compost, and probably about $3-4, depending where you go. But as you can see here, this compost has a whole lot of wood chips in it. So instead of mixing it in with the garden mix and having it down at the bottom where it takes the nitrogen away from the plants, which they need to, of course, fruit, I went ahead and filled the raised beds with the garden mix, added 2 inches of this on top, and watered it in. So all the compost and nutrients went down to the bottom, and the wood chips stayed on top, which created a moisture barrier. And that's what I came up with. I mean, if anybody has a better idea, please let me know, because I can't take this back. So, or I don't know if they would take it back, but I doubt they would. I have them in these large pots here, because if you're from Houston, or if you visited Houston, you know that Houston has a very bad ant problem. Everywhere you go, there's fire ants everywhere. So what I was going to do is just lay the plastic down on the ground, back the trailer up, dump it on the ground, and leave it. But then I thought, I don't want my nieces to come out here, or my parents to come out here, dig their hands in there to try to, you know, get some soil to plant their plants. And then they get a big old handful of ants. That wouldn't be cool. So I'm not saying this is ant-proof, but since we had a whole bunch of these large pots, you know, available, that'll be in the greenhouse video. But we have a whole bunch of these large pots. It has some extra pallets. So I decided to go ahead and put the pots on the pallets and the dirt in the pots. So, like I was saying, it's not ant-proof, but it takes a little bit more effort for them to come up here and just start another ant pile. I do cover it up, and I do have it covered. I took the cover off just for video purposes. But as you can see, I mean, it works just great. I got it off the ground. I don't have to worry about weeds coming through or anything like that. And it does its purpose. So either way, y'all come with me over here. That, I still taste that. And although this is not necessarily the compost section, but it does have to do with the compost bins and everything. If you look at this from the street, if somebody doesn't know what it is, like we do, they would think, wow, that looks ugly. So I decided to go ahead and plant the banana trees here. And as they grow, they'll leaf out, cover it up, and no more compost bins. But I know, and you know, that we got some compost going on back there. Same thing here, that's why I had this pallet here. I have some small banana trees. There were pups that came from the banana runs over there. Decided to put them in pots, put them up here. I'll get another pallet put there and just fill this whole area with banana trees, and just have it covered up, look a little more prettier, more presentable. And my dad would be more happier, because he kind of looked at this thing like, yeah. And I said, yeah. And he said, yeah. And I said, what? He said, what? I'm like, okay. So either way, it actually went down like that too. So. All right, well, till next time, man, I appreciate you coming to the 4G Experience again. I'm George. Talk to you later.